The first speaker has lied many times at his workplace to be here on time at Toastmasters, Bangalore Toastmasters Club. An innovator at heart, he is the creative director and the CEO of renewable startup Abhi Solar.
As a Toastmaster, he's been here for the last 2 decades. And I've known him personally. A person who's began his career in a very humble way to what he is now. This Toastmaster is going to present his speech.
Motivation Overdose.
Motivation Overdose.
Bye. Please welcome on stage the one-liner, Somshekhar.
Fear in his voice. The patient asked the surgeon, he was undergoing a critical surgery. He asked the surgeon, "Am I going to survive?" The doctor replied, "Yes, absolutely you will survive." "How can we be so confident?" asked the patient. The doctor replied, 9 out of 10 patients die during this surgery. Yesterday died my 9th patient." Fellow Toastmasters, my dear guests, is 100% sure that we all will die one day. What really matters is how we live our life, right? All of us have a limited lifespan. How do you make use of this? That depends on us. A famous Chinese philosopher, not Nitin, Lao Tzu, he said, "If you are depressed, you are living in the past. If you are anxious, you are living in the future. If you are at peace, you are living at the present." I think that's very important. For us, if you want to make the best from life, you need to live in the present. And to live in the present, don't we all need a dose of motivation here and there?
Yes.
But what happens when we really get an overdose of motivation, which is what is happening in this world? 2 decades back, the main source of motivation used to be those self-help books, biographies of great leaders who have transformed the world. But today, after the internet boom, social media storm, what has happened? YouTube videos, WhatsApp messages, tweets, these are bombarding you so much so that morning you wake up, you don't say good morning to the near one who's in the bed. You pick up the phone and send good morning messages to all those people. That, I call it as an overdose. Dear friends, a month back when the Pulwama attack happened, the WhatsApp messages, they were just flooding. Everyone became so patriotic, right? Sending messages. But what did we really achieve? Does that really work? Instead, I'll tell you, we need to take action. Even today, go to Majestic, go to Cantonment Station. You will find that Jawan with those big trunks sitting there. If you really want to contribute, hug that gentleman, the Jawan, and tell him, thank you. How much we feel safe because of that. Those parents, you know, they want to send their son there and they are not sure that he will come back or not. Wipe their tears. Wipe your tears. You need to take action. Motivation is just an emotional level. That has got a validity time. It just dies off. Taking action is the important thing. 22 years back, Mr. Robinson D'Souza, Claudius Pereira, Siraj Rahman, Peter Anil Rigo. Well, that time we didn't have internet, we didn't have cell phones, we just had, I think, 5 members, if I remember. The struggle they had to build this club. Luckily, I was part of the team then. I call them the Wolf. I think that's the kind of motivation we need. The people around you, they can really motivate you, not the messages. I think that's the reason we come here week after week. Well, it just doesn't end there. So they gave the beginning, but later, people like John Bosco Abraham, he showed what discipline is. 1 year as a secretary, he never missed a single meeting. So that's what really energized me to be in this club, coming here even after 22 years. And now what motivates me? The young generation here, every Friday when I come here. Abhay, Vijay, right? Deepika, Shilpa, Simran, Melvin, everyone. Everyone. I can't tell all the names. Yeah, right?
You can
understand. Right? So all of them, with their fresh energy, new ideas. I think there's so much to learn from every generation. My appeal to you is, don't be a slave to motivation. Be the source of motivation. You be the source. It's not that necessary that you know you need to really motivate a huge crowd there like Swami Nityananda. No, you can motivate your spouse, your children, your family, your friends. That's where the real motivation happens. Don't be in the virtual world, be in the real world. My dear friends, in the savanna forests, not savanna forest, savanna is a grassland, savannas of Africa, the lion wakes up and every morning thinks, today I need to run faster than the slowest gazelle. In the savannas, the gazelle wakes up that day and it thinks to itself, today I need to run faster than the fastest lion. No matter it's a lion or a gazelle, you need to run. Remember this, every morning when you wake up, don't snatch out to that spot. Reach out to your running shoes and get into the act. Over to you.